motorcade by now.
States be willing to enter into those negotiations between Syria and Israel if as Yitzhak Shamir has indicated, they request it?
Well, I don't think it'd be good for me to comment now or what might be, or get into hypotheticals. We're interested in peace in the Middle East and what to do with that.
Will that be one of the subjects of your luncheon today, sir?
Well, it depends. Everyone's free here to put things on the table.
Is the U.S. ready to get more involved diplomatically worldwide, sir?
I don't know how much more we could be involved than we have here.
Thank you.
Sometimes people remark that I miss it, but there is a very definite seasonal pattern. It's just a different thing. Different parts of our country, our seasonality varies.
We have a 6-month rainy season and a 6-month dry season. In the fall, when the rain starts, and everything gets green.
When I first moved out there, and we've been through this stretch with no rain, of course, everything's rising right out. I remarked on how brown the hills were, and the longtime Californians immediately corrected me. Said they're not brown, they're gold.
Some deal of them or something.
Yeah, that's
right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mr. President, was there negligence in Beirut?
What do you think happened then if there wasn't negligence?
We've only been in that building for 2 months. About 75% of all of the work that had to be done had been completed.
true that it was not quite completed. But it's the same thing that's happened to the other place. Someone determined to kill himself, exploding the automobile. They did their best. They were firing at him almost from the beginning. They got close to it. He never did get into the compound.
Well, don't you think they moved in too soon? Moved into the building until they should have waited until security was complete.
No, we're waiting for the complete report of the two that we sent over there and then come back and tell us those complete details. But we moved into that building because it represented more safety than the one that we were in.
Was it a mistake to pull out that marine detachment, Mr. President?
No. You can't have exterior guards. Marines cannot be exterior guards outside the compound. That is foreign territory. And there was no need inside the compound for the detachment of 80 Marines.
Do you think they're going to be safer from now on, or is there any place that's safe for them in Beirut?
There are additional things that still had to be done. For example, the steel gates were hung because of the wet concrete and so forth. But this is what we'll hear when they come back to us. But it was the move was made because it was represented a safer territory, a safer building. Work had to be done. Anyone that's ever had their kitchen done over knows that it never gets done as soon as you wish it would.
But sir, couldn't they have blocked the entrance more effectively? Couldn't they have blocked the entrance more effectively?
Thank you, Jerry.
We're talking about a residential street. The people must have access to that street. We cannot completely close off that street. There are people. That's a residential area that live on that street. And we had the blocks up. We had the mine steel work up to keep them from going around the blocks. The gate was not opened. But as I say, there was a checkpoint there. They were stopped. When they began to step on it, they were fired upon. And they got just short of the building, the corner of the building, and they detonated the car.
Would you recommend, sir, that more Marines be sent in to be on security?
No, that wasn't the problem, as I say. We have guards. We get there, but you either do that or the host country provides the outside protection. But your Marines could not be outside the compound guarding non-Lebanese territory.
Thank you.
When do you think you'll get a complete report?
Thank you.
When will you get your complete report on the subject?
Thank you.
Ambassador Oakley.
Thank you all.
And Deputy Assistant Secretary Fields will be back tomorrow afternoon with the preliminary assessment that they've been making.
Thank you.
And I come home the day before, on the Monday. So on the Tuesday I received his credentials, and the next day both of us were
received.
I received 7 ambassadors that one day. The first in order of precedence was the third ambassador, and your ambassador was last in order of precedence.
You were out of one pack, did you?
Lights, please.
Mr. President, what are you prepared to tell Foreign Minister Gromyko when you meet him this evening?
I broke the rule and took some questions the first time in here because of the immediacy of that problem, but now with the head of state visiting us here, why I'm not going to take questions. I've been doing it for a week, though, very, very freely speaking out, but I think now we've...
But aren't the questions getting better? Aren't the questions getting better?
How about an African question? How about an African question? Soviet arms shipments to Africa, how do you feel about them? Apparently there's a pickup in Soviet arms shipments to Southern Africa. Is that something you're looking for help on or alarmed about?
You'll hear some words about that in my address to the United Nations.
I know.
Come in.